Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and Apple released watchOS 8.6 RC, or Release Candidate. This is the final version that should be released to developers and beta testers before it's released to the public. As long as Apple finds no additional issues, this will be the final version. Now this came in at 139 megabytes, that's on my Series 7 Apple Watch, but it can vary between 100 to 200 megabytes depending on the watch you have. Now let's take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go over to our settings and you'll see I'm already under the build number, but if you want to find that, you can go to General, then About, and you'll see the build number is 19T572. And this particular build does include a new feature and then also a couple features depending on where you live. Now the first thing is pretty big if you use accessibility. So that can be found on your watch or on the iPhone under the Watch app. So if we go on the iPhone under the Watch app, under Watch, if we go down to Accessibility, under Accessibility, go to VoiceOver. Under VoiceOver, scroll down to Hand Gestures and go to the Customization of the Gesture section. We now have the option for Magic Tap. This is super helpful for those of you that use iPads or iPhones. Now we have it on the Apple Watch with 8.6. So you can double tap with two fingers and you'll get some new options. So that's something they've brought to the Apple Watch with 8.6. Now they've also updated this with ECG features for new countries. So if you're in different countries using ECG, maybe you want to check your heart rate or measure your ECG overall, you can now do that in Mexico. So that's something they've added in 8.6 for Mexico, as well as irregular heart rhythm. So that's something they've added also. Now, as far as bug fixes or anything else, well, Apple hasn't mentioned anything regarding that. However, they did mention that there will be security updates, but they so far have not updated their security website. Typically, they won't do this until the final release is released to the public. So you can see the Apple security website, and if we scroll down, they only have the last version of watchOS, 8.5.1. So that's what's currently available right now. We don't know what the actual security updates will be until after Apple releases it to the public. So we'll look for that as soon as we know. Now, as far as when to expect the release to the public, well, typically we can expect these usually the following week, unless they find additional issues. We haven't really seen a watchOS RC2 very often, so we can usually expect this typically around probably Monday or Tuesday of next week. So maybe the 16th or 17th of May. That's typically what I would expect with this update. Then later that week, we'll probably see a watchOS 8.7 update as well. So normally Apple will release all of these updates at the same time, such as iOS 15.5 and tvOS 15.5 and macOS 12.4. All of those are expected to be released along with watchOS 8.6. And then we'll move on to iOS 15.6 betas, watchOS 8.7 betas probably later next week. Then later, once we get to June, we'll have iOS 16 beta 1 along with watchOS 9 beta 1. That will be on June 6th, where they'll release the first betas of those. We'll see all of the new features then. So at this point, don't expect too many new features until we get watchOS 9 and iOS 16 and iPadOS 16 and so on. We'll have betas with those along with watchOS 8 betas all the way up until September, where we maybe get a new Apple Watch Series 8 and a new watchOS 9. So that's typically what Apple does every single year. You can expect the same sort of rollout this year as well. So there's not a whole lot going on in watchOS 8.6, just three features overall. But of course, if you found anything else I haven't mentioned in the video, please let me know in the comments below. Of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.